defeated Rio Chonan. And it was interesting because Chonan was the last guy to legitimately defeat UFC middleweight champion Anderson Silva with one of the slickest submissions. That took place on New Year's Eve, Stephen, at Pride Shockwave 2004.
Quite lineage, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt. He does have one punch knockout power, but I'm sure Phil would love for him to trade with him tonight.
What I like about Sakurai, he is a well-rounded martial artist, studies everything, always improving. And like you said, he doesn't look big. This guy can bang.
ただいまより本日の第3試合、ウェルター級ワンマッチを行います。青コーナー、175センチ、76.1 キロ、フィル・バローネ。赤コーナー、171センチ、76.5 キロ、サクライ・マッハ。
We are set for action in the dream welterweight division. Japan's Hayato Maha Sakurai squaring off with the United States' Phil Baroni. Referee going through the last minute instructions. Sakurai made his pro debut in the Shooter organization back in October of 1996, submitting Japanese pioneer Kaoru. At one time considered one of the pound-for-pound best fighters in the sport, Baroni immediately bull rushes him into the clinch.
Bull rushed him off a right hand that Sakurai slipped.
Both of them known for their punching power. Baroni has 10 wins by way of knockout. Sakurai with 11. But Sakurai, more well-rounded. 10 submission wins as well.
Phil Baroni cut a lot of weight for this fight. Got down 167 pounds. We saw maybe about 173. He was really struggling with those last few pounds. He was very unhappy, kind of croaky in his voice. I hope it doesn't affect his stamina tonight.
His main sparring partner at AKA in San Jose is former Strikeforce lightweight champion Josh Thompson. But as you mentioned, a murderer's row of wrestlers at AKA with the likes of Daniel Cormier, Cain Velasquez, and John Fitch. So if Baroni wanted to go back to his wrestling roots, he picked the right place.
And he's doing just that right now.
He's made up his mind.
He's got the over-under. He's got Sakurai pinned up against the corner, and he's trying to pick off that leg. But he ate a knee to the liver, and that's going to add up.
Baroni also said he had a slap tear in his left shoulder. It's been bugging him for years. He finally got it fixed. He kind of made excuses that being part of our fight.
One of the most memorable fights in Strikeforce history, that fight with you and Phil Baroni, and that was where you unveiled the go-to-sleep gesture that none other than WWE superstar CM Punk seems to have purloined.
Mickey Rourke stole it too, but blessings to Mickey. I love it.
I tell you, when you try to explain to our Japanese contingency the sleeping move, they didn't quite get it.
Sakurai now handcuffing Baroni along the ropes. Baroni looking to drop levels, maybe going for the takedown, but
another one of those knees to the ribs by Sakurai.
Short knee strike from Maha Sakurai. His nickname comes from Japanese pro wrestler Higo Shigashashi, better known as Maha Hayato. And there's a takedown by Baroni into a half butterfly guard. So Baroni in top position.
Sakurai real tight with this butterfly guard. Watch his feet on the hips, on the inside, pushing the knees out. He's very active when he gets down here.
With a full butterfly guard, could look for the elevator sweep, but Baroni creating distance, working the body with punches. Sakurai striking from bottom position. Just past the midway point of the opening round. We are scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds here in the Dream Welterweight Division. There's some old school heel strikes on the Hoist Gracie.
Sakurai keeping that guard open, heels on hips, wanting to spring up. Phil Baroni trying but missing with a lot of those shots. Sakurai really keeping his options open.
Yeah, you see what he's doing. It's hard to tell, but he's holding the gloves with his elbow. Sakurai is stretching Phil's hips out. So he doesn't have any arm power. He's got total wrist control on him. And every time he goes to punch, Sakurai moves his head or lifts his arm up the block.
Baroni continues to blast away on Sakurai, not really getting all of those punches on target. Under a minute 45 seconds remaining in the first frame.
Sakurai's really isolating that right arm of Phil Baroni there. Like you said, Frank,
there's some windshield.
It's very deceptive.
From the bottom. The hammer fist from the bottom by Sakurai. 90 seconds now remaining in the opening round. And Sakurai doing a better job of striking to the bottom than Phil Baroni, although Baroni just landed the right hand.
Well, it looks like Sakurai's trying to hit him, get him to hit back hard, and advance that knee up into a submission.
And that's all kinds of old school stuff. We had Baroni almost going for the can opener.
Baroni with two arms straightening out there, that's going to be dangerous, but he knows that if he goes for an arm bar, he can pass the guard.
Final 60 seconds here left in round one, and Sakurai again remaining active from his back. Hammer fist from the bottom by Sakurai, and Baroni not really throwing back with the same volume.
Not what I expected in this match at all. But then again, that's a good thing. I like to be surprised. Slower pace, though.
Sakurai's just kind of stalemated the whole advance of Baroni. And it looks like Baroni doesn't want to stand.
And Baroni now standing up. Referee will bring Sakurai back to his feet. Final 20 seconds of the opening round. Tie clinch, knee up the middle by Sakurai. Knee from Baroni, glances with the right hand, misses with the left. Final 10 seconds, Sakurai going through the guard of Baroni.
Uh-oh.
And Sakurai and Baroni coming back now as we are headed to round two here at Dream 18.
Baroni took a lot of damage in the body here. That's what you can't tell, these short knees, these little shots. It's just sucking the life out of Phil's body. And he didn't want to on the stand up because he took it down as soon as he had a chance. I thought he could have tried to advance more positions, but very few shots were getting in. Sakurai lifting the hands up, moving the head a lot, keeping the feet on the hips. He really sort of shut down Phil Baroni's ground attack here, which is usually pretty deadly. And then when they got up, all Sakurai on landing them shots, very surprised at the passivity and Phil backing up here. Now, after he took all these shots, you see him come back for a minute. By then, it's too late. He's already been kind of banged up and pushed up on the cage, or on the rope, I'm sorry.
And Sakurai landed every one of those shots at the end of that round. Sakurai really looked good in that round.
Sakurai's face during his illustrious career, some of the biggest names in the sport, including former Pride lightweight champion Takanori Gomi, former UFC welterweight champion Matt Hughes, and current UFC middleweight champion Anderson Silva. Phil Baroni regrouping after a tough opening round. We are set for the second round. Baroni enjoyed a lot of time in top position, but it was Sakurai doing a lot of the damage. A quick start by Baroni as he again looks for the double leg takedown, and great takedown defense by Sakurai.
Sakurai seemed to ease in the block of his takedown.
Just deadened his weight and dropped down, bent his knees. Yeah. There it was.
He was looking at the crowd while he was doing it, too. He just completely shut it down.
Awesome.
Well, Phil did some great head kicks in his last fight. He really feels like, with his emphasis on wrestling, he can stand up more, he can throw more, but I've seen no kicks out of this fight whatsoever.
You hear the referee yell the word action. There is, at his discretion, the opportunity. Oh, and almost an Uchimata, modified Uchimata there, due to takedown by Sakurai to side control. I was going to say that the referee can give yellow cards for passivity.
Oh.
And beautiful transition into full mount by Sakurai. And this could be very perilous for Baroni. Needs to be active on the ground.
Baroni gets a hip escape back in the guard.
And he eats a right hand for his efforts. Under 2 minutes, or just past the 2 minute mark.
Phil's got to be careful not to give up into side mount, because then there it is right there. Sakurai passes.
I was never good at math in school. Minute 15 into the second round. Thank you.
Now look at Sakurai. He's holding the right shoulder of Phil, lifting it up. He's going to try to step on the other arm, crucify him on the mat, and then punch him right in the head.
Now Baroni's given up his back. Looking for the switch. Stand up and is able to get back to his feet. So good job by Baroni, looking for the takedown. Stuffed by Sakurai, pummeling. As Baroni backed up along the ropes now. Knee strike by Sakurai. Baroni with a short right uppercut glances off the chin.
Frank, you said something in the round number one about the weight cut hampering his, energy. I think that's what we're seeing here.
Yeah.
Body shot with the right hand by Baroni.
Nice low kick by Sakurai.
Overhand right by Baroni again to the clinch they go. Under 3 minutes now remaining in the second stanza. Baroni able to turn the tables on Sakurai, drops, levels, and well, Sakurai kind of just went to the canvas pulling guard as Baroni was looking for the takedown.
And we're going to see a restart of the fighters closer to the center. Keep them from sliding out of the ring.
Of course, North American audience is used to the cage, but here in Japan, where Pride made the ring famous for mixed martial arts, you'll see things like that throughout the contest. Again, Baroni working the body, but Sakurai busy on the bottom with hammer fists and right hands.
Phil's got to—he's got to make a statement here from the top because he wasn't doing very well standing. He's in a perfect position to land some shots. Just got to be careful with the legs of Sakurai in the submission.
Sakurai, good job of keeping him at bay. His feet on Baroni's hips, controlling his posture.
He's just got him tied up on the ground. Baroni's got no power. He can't posture in a strong position. And I feel like Sakurai's just sucking a life out of him. Wearing him down.
Apparently so. Under 2 minutes remaining in the round again. Baroni making the long flight from the UFC on his own. But has Henson anyway and Ricky Fukuda in his corner making the tough weight cut. He talked about the fact that originally was supposed to fight at 172 pounds and now 168. He weighed in at 167.
Phil doing a lot of positional maneuvering, but he's not being as aggressive because we know that dream fights are not scored on a round-by-round basis.
Don't worry, Stephen, old habits die hard, my friend. I go.
I'm sure you're going to bust that move the same way I did. But it's like, is he saving it up for the last round? I don't know. Right now, it seems that Sakurai is catching a breather.
And that's an interesting ruling that Dream has. You judge the fight in its entirety, because that really takes a different strategy when you get into it. Because you need to win every little bit, or just blow it out in the last round.
Like, reminder to our fans watching on CBS Sportsnet in the United States or on Fight Network in Canada. While they are 3 5-minute rounds, the fight is indeed judged in its entirety, just like in the Pride days. So there's no 10-point must system. The criteria, just like Pride, the effort to finish the fight by knockout or submission, as Sakurai goes for a submission, is number one in the criteria. And I think the entire sport should adopt that as their number one criteria. And now Baroni with some ground and pound here in the latter stages of the second stanza. Up kick from Sakurai. 15 seconds left in the round. And again, Baroni working from the half guard, half butterfly guard up Sakurai. And Sakurai seems to be very content from being in this position, every so often throwing up some offensive strikes of his own, as the third round is straight ahead here at Dream 18.
Well, Phil, it's got to be feeling it. Sakurai seemed to slow down a little bit at the end of the round, but I couldn't tell if he was just coasting or just kind of feeling where the chi was. Here's a beautiful hip cut toss. Whatever it was, it got him in the perfect position. He got right around Phil's guard and, of course, advanced that into the mount position where I was hoping he'd do a little bit more damage. Phil's not usually good on his back off that position, but was able to get back to the guard.
I said it was a modified Uchimata. In fact, upon further review, it was a modified Haregoshin.
Oh, Haregoshin, excuse me. I was going to call it a leg trippy fall down thing.
Can I have noodles with that?
I'd like some. Sakurai, though, doing great job as damaging from his back. Not just staying there passively. Those kicks coming up, those short shots to the head, those are all working.
Sakurai controlling this fight so far. We're just waiting for the New York Badass to show up.
Fight! The bell and the third and final round underway of this dream welterweight matchup between Phil Baroni and Hayato Sakurai. Sakurai, a BJJ black belt who competed in the prestigious Abu Dhabi Combat Club Submission Wrestling Tournament back in 1999, has been able to control Phil Baroni from the bottom. And now another wardrobe malfunction here as we have another problem with the gloves.
Phil did the same thing that round. Came out through one punch, went right into a grappling match.
I don't think he really wants to. Oh, and he got stunned right there with the left shot from Sakurai.
Oh, the uppercut. Baroni saying, let's bring it on then, let's do this thing. And I remember Baroni in his Pride debut against Ikuisa Minowa. It turned into a brawl and a slugfest. And Baroni at this stage of this fight, that's probably what he wants to turn this into. And he's finally being able to land some shots on Sakurai. But there's that beautiful right uppercut by the Japanese fighter.
I agree, Mauro. I think that Phil Baroni fights better when he's emotional. I think he's getting emotional now, and he needs that to really pull this one off.
And Baroni unloading the heavy artillery.
I think he
Sakurai.
Hurt Sakurai.
Yeah. That goes for the takedown, the sprawl by Baroni, beautifully stuffing the takedown and working on the knees to the head of a grounded opponent, which were allowed here in Dream.
Phil caught him with a good shot. Sakurai shot for the takedown.
Right hand connects by Baroni. Throwing caution to the wind, and this is the time to do it. Third and final round.
Sakurai
left by Sakurai.
He's finding a spot for that jab.
Phil does not move his head. He moves his shoulders. He doesn't move his head. So if you just pop as soon as he moves straight down the center, you'll touch him.
Another jab from Sakurai, overhand right. Baroni on the ropes, pummeling now. Sakurai putting all of his weight on him. And now Baroni just explodes off the ropes looking for the takedown, defended by Sakurai going for the guillotine.
Superb takedown defense by Sakurai. Fell down there low, starting to bleed on his forehead.
And hammer fist from the back by Sakurai. Baroni in the turtle position there, now just in the wrestler's position, cross-faced by Sakurai, knee to the body. Baroni trying to turn the tables, looking for the sweep or the scramble.
He's putting a lot of energy into this.
And he does it, beautiful escape by Baroni in a top position and in the half butterfly guard. So Baroni getting the better of that scramble. Just past the midway point of the final round.
I feel like Baroni's dug himself a hole. He's got to dig himself out now. He's got to start either bringing some damage or looking real spectacular.
Delivering right hands to the side of Sakurai's face. Again, Sakurai very comfortable from this position. Baroni trying to improve his position.
Baroni is a lot more energetic in this round and is really putting it out there. I think he knows that if it were a point fight and you add up the scorecards, he would be losing. But in this particular thing, he's going to make an impression. But he's got to do damage.
Under 2 minutes remaining in the fight. Phil Baroni, the New York badass, training full-time at American Kickboxing Academy in San Jose, California, returning to Japan to face one of Japan's best in Hayato Sakurai, who represents his own Maha Dojo. While Sakurai may be in the, both of these guys, let's face it, perhaps the twilight of their respective careers, both wanting to put it on the line here in the final minute and 24 seconds. There's been a lot of wear and tear on these two gladiators over the years. Baroni with the right uppercut, left hook combination. And Sakurai took it and delivered a one-two of his own. That backed up Baroni.
Sakurai put Baroni on his heels with that right hand. It's that straight punch. Frank, you said it.
Yeah, I found out in the Baroni fight. Baroni's like a wounded animal. You wound him, he comes right back.
We could be in for a furious finish. The final minute of this fight. Baroni goes for the right hand, changes levels, and is scuffed on the takedown attempt with the sprawl by Sakurai. But Baroni up on his feet. High plumb by Sakurai. The knee delivered to the midsection. Uppercut by Baroni. He hasn't really been able to do a lot of damage, which is surprising. The weight cut may have really depleted his power.
And
there's a one-two combination from Sakurai.
He's jamming up his own punches because he wants to wrestle.
25 seconds left in the fight. Sakurai closes the distance.
Baroni doesn't have the pop he used to.
15 seconds left in the fight. Both of them may be showing a little fatigue while bouncing up and down a Sakurai. One-two combination. Baroni stops.
Whoa! What a finish.
So Hayato Sakurai and Phil Baroni go the distance, with Hayato Sakurai seemingly getting the better of the New York Badass in all facets of the fight.
I tell you, they went for gunslinging heaven right here in the last round. They were both shooting it out, but it was the straight punches, as Frank was talking about. But Baroni landed some good leather right there with that left hook to the temple, but Sakurai just shook it right off and pressed forward and was the more energetic fighter by the end, and he was landing constantly.
Yeah, Sakurai, nice combinations. He got the range. It was his range. He controlled the range, and when he wanted to pop, he got counter hit a few times, but he was landing more shots more frequently, and especially when he led with that jab and these short counter shots, just money. The inside fighting in those last few seconds was some dangerous game.
He's known as a New York Badass, and one thing's for sure, he has the fighting heart the size of New York. Let's go to the official decision. It's a clean sweep on the judges' scorecards. Hayato Maha Sakurai improves to 37-12-2 in his professional career. Phil Baroni drops to 15-16, losing via unanimous decision in his return to Japan.
It's the weight cut. He didn't have the energy. He ran out of gas early.
Yeah, and he looked good, and he had a plan. He was going to wrestle, which, you know, he said he's been working hard on, but all the energy was gone by halfway and, you know, the end of that round.
And Hayato Sakurai improves to 5-3 on New Year's Eve. You're watching Dream 18 on CBS Sportsnet in the United States.